Yes, dear students, today we will discuss ethosuximide. Ethosuximide belongs to which category? That is anti-epileptic. Anti-epileptic means drugs which are used to treat epilepsy. Similarly, this ethosuximide also belongs to subcategory of anti-epileptic, that is succinamide. Okay, and what is the mechanism of action of ethosuximide and how it is used and what is the synthetic route for the ethosuximide? With that things we will discuss completely related to ethosuximide. Let us discuss one by one, that is ethosuximide. Ethosuximide, that is belongs to that is anti-epileptic. Anti-epileptic have a subcategory, that is succinamide. How it is succinamide, we will discuss also. It belongs to therapeutically calcium channel blocker, means it block the calcium channels. Okay, just try to understand the related to mechanism of action. It partial antagonize T-type of calcium channel, means there are certain different calcium channels. T-type calcium channels are antagonized, means antagonized means blockage. Okay, means that ethosuximide block that calcium channel, which results what will happen? Decrease blast firing of thalamocortical neurons. What will happen? Try to understand. In epilepsy, there is a high or excited level of neurons, that is firing off continuously, which results convulsions of in a particular patient. Means if we will reduce the or we stabilize the neuron, particular neuron, in that situation there will be no convulsions or no epilepsy in respective person. Here we are blocking the calcium channel, and that blockage have the effect of on the thalamocortical neurons, which were decreased blast firing, means there is a decreased excitement of respective neurons. Okay, which results what will happen? Stabilize nerve activity in brain. In brain there is an activity is decreased. Okay, which results the prevent seizures. Seizures also known as convulsions. Okay, this is the general mechanism of ethosuximide. Okay, now uses of ethosuximide is the only and only one, and that is the treatment of absent seizures. Absent seizures also known as paroxysmal seizures or paroxysmal convulsions. There are certain different types of convulsions or seizures that are present in epilepsy. And that epilepsy is generally present in adult as well as children. Means usage of ethosuximide treatment of absent seizures that are also known as paroxysmal in adult as well as children. Okay, means this drug is equally tolerated by adult as well as children. Clear? This is all about the mechanism action and uses. Now come to the synthesis and the structure of ethosuximide. What is the structure? This is the ethosuximide structure. Okay, to synthesize this molecule, we have this certain pathway to pathway for the synthesis. How it is, try to understand. Okay, this is synthetic pathway. First synthetic step, that first synthetic step is a very important, that is basically novel gain condensation. Novel gain condensation, what is that? Basically here this is, see, try to understand what is this molecule. Try to understand, suppose I am just writing CH3COOC2H5. This is ethyl acetate. This is ethyl acetate. Okay, that ethyl acetate have a cyano group. This is CH, this is the ethyl acetate, that is the cyano group, means cyano ethyl acetate. Similarly, here what is this? 1, 2, 2, 3, 4. 4. Matlab, what is this? That is a ketone form, and this one the methyl, this one the ethyl, and this one the ketone. Means methyl, ethyl, ketone. Okay, that is ester basically. That is ester, and that is the ketone form. Okay, that ester and ketone have a novel chain condensation where what will happen, that keep this hydrogen and this oxygen removed as a water molecule, and both ester and ketone will condense to form double bond in between this ketone moiety and this ester moiety. Okay, this is the double bond, the double bond in between what, ketone and ester moiety. Okay, in next step, what is here the double bond, and then we are going to reaction with HCN in presence of C2H5OH, means ethanol. That is the reaction with the HCN, hydrogen cyanide. Hydrogen cyanide, very simple attachment of hydrogen and cyano group is this here, means cyano group here and cyano group here, and the hydrogen will be here. Okay, means that is simply second reaction, that is nucleophilic, that is nucleophilic addition reaction, that is nucleophilic addition reaction. Okay, in next step what is this, cyano group here, two cyano group, that is cyano group. Okay, that are cyano group, and this one the our ester group. Okay, this is the ester group. Here we are going to treat with acid. Acid and water molecule, means reaction number third, that is simply cyano group will reduce hydrolyzed in respective carboxylic acid, and ester group again hydrolyzed to respective carboxylic acid, means third reaction, that is hydrolysis. That is hydrolysis. Hydrolysis means this ester group will convert into carboxylic group. At the same time, cyano group will get carboxylic group, cyano group into carboxylic group. Okay, this is our dicarboxylate derivative. Dicarboxylate derivative undergo by means of heating. If we are going to at high temperature, this sign is heating process. This is heating process, and we here if we heat that molecule here, that this carbon have two carboxylic group, here one carboxylic and one carboxylic group. If at high temperature, then it removes CO2 in this form. That means this reaction known as, that is fourth reaction, decarboxylation reaction. Decarboxylation reaction means removal of CO2. Clear? Means this carboxylic group will removed as CO2. This is our intermediate. That is dicarboxylic. This one the tricarboxylic, because three carboxylic groups are present, it is dicarboxylic acid. Okay, that is our fourth reaction. In next step reaction with the here we are going to two reaction with ammonia. Then in the carboxylic group form with ammonia, carboxylic group with ammonia form salt formation, that is ammonium salt. Okay, salt formation. Clear? And in next reaction, that is the removal of ammonia molecule, due to heating, removal of water molecule, which results amide formation. Means that is respective carboxylic group will convert into respective carboxylic amide group here. This reaction known as, commonly known as reaction number 5, that is amide formation. Okay. And in last step, diamide linkages are there. Here just we are going to heat this molecule. What will happen? Removal of one amino group, have a hydrogen from this one, and remove as NH3 as ammonia molecule, and this reaction, sixth reaction known as cyclization. This reaction known as cyclization. Okay, that is the ethosuximide. Yes, this CH2 have this carbon, and this carbon is the this carbon have a CH3 and ethyl moiety, a CH3 and ethyl moiety, and this nitrogen only one nitrogen because two nitrogens, two amino groups are removed as a one ammonia form, and this is the keto form. This was the keto form. Okay, this is the ethosuximide. Then how we can this structure remember this, that is the ethosuximide. Try to understand ethosuximide. I am just again drawing the structure, that is the ethosuximide. This one the ethosuximide, two nitrogen, one nitrogen and two keto group, one is the ethyl group and one ethyl group. This is the molecule ethosuximide. Okay, then try to understand here. Arth means ethyl. O means ketone. Succinamide means succinamide. And what is the succinamide? Try to understand. Just I am giving a quick review related to this molecule, succinamide. Suppose this one CH2 and CH2 C double OH. This one the succinic acid. Okay, this one the succinic acid. If I will remove OH and remove OH of both molecules, then put a one and nitrogen, that is the succinamide. That is the succinamide. Okay, this molecule is the succinamide, and this molecule is present in the ethosuximide structure. That's why it is known as succinamide derivative. Okay, this is all about what, that is the ethosuximide. Etho means ethyl group, and O means ketone group, and succinamide. Okay, just have a quick review related to this molecule. Ethosuximide belongs to anti-epileptic, succinamide, calcium channel blocker. Calcium channel, due to the calcium channel blocker, there is a stabilization of nerve activity in brain. That's why it is prevent the seizures. Because of it preventing the seizures, that's why it is used in the treatment of absence seizure, that is the paritimal seizures in children as well as adult. Okay, in the synthesis, the first one, the ethyl acetate and derivative reacted with the ketone form, that is the Novalgene condensation, which results the condensed product followed by HCN addition, that is nucleophilic addition, and followed by acidic hydrolysis, which results the tricarboxylic derivative, butyrate, which results the decarboxylation and formation of dicarboxylic acid. Dicarboxylic derivative treated with this ammonia, which results the formation of salt, that is ammonium salt formation, which ammonium salt formation heated by which give the removal of water molecule, and have diamide formation also again heated to form as ethosuximide by mean of cyclization. This is all about that ethosuximide in during if university exam, then there will be one question that is write short note on ethosuximide. Then you have to produce all points, that is mechanism action, usage as well as the synthesis. At the if examiner asks the only synthesis, means write the synthesis of ethosuximide, then you have to present only synthesis. In competitive exam, there may be question that is related to mechanism action, which type of calcium channel blocks by mean of ethosuximide, then you have to remember T calcium channel blocker, and which type of seizures are treated with ethosuximide. In that time you have to remember two points or two words, that is the absence seizures as well as paritimal seizures. Also one question may be there, which anti-epileptic is safely used in adult and children, that is again ethosuximide. Okay, this is all about ethosuximide. Clear?